Recall the peripheral nervous system is made up of cranial nerves and spinal nerves. Well, right now our job is to learn the cranial nerves. There's 12 pairs of them, and they're numbered 1 through 12, Roman numerals 1 through 12. So our job is to learn the 12 cranial nerves, their number, whether they're mixed, sensory, right, or motor, and what their function is. So these are just ways to remember the cranial nerves. Just the first letter of each word here corresponds to a cranial nerve. There's lots of different mnemonics to learn them, but I'm just going to go through the 12 cranial nerves and exactly what you need to know for each of the 12. In lab, we labeled the cranial nerves. So if you're in my lab, you'll have that video on the brain model labeling each of the 12 cranial nerves. And of course, they're on each side. So we have number 1, right, number 2, right, and so on and so forth. But we're going to look at each one individually here. This graph you can refer back to after. It's a summary of the 12 cranial nerves. It's two slides here. Here's 1 through 5, the Roman numeral, the name of the nerve, its function. And so these three lines, this line, and this line are the three lines that we're going to go through in the upcoming slides. Here's page 2 of the summary that you can refer back to later to study, right? There's we're cranial nerves 6 through 12 here, their name and the function. Be a good summary for you to just kind of study with the cranial nerves with, but let's go through each one individually. I'm going to highlight everything you need to know for each cranial nerve. So start with cranial nerve 1. Roman numeral 1 is the olfactory nerve. Olfactory nerve, is it motor, sensory, or mixed? Well, you can see here and here, it's sensory, purely sensory, no motor at all. So cranial nerve 1, olfactory nerve, is the sensory nerve. Well, sensory for what? Well, what it's named for, olfactory function, which means your sense of smell. And here we can see the olfactory nerve, also called the olfactory bulb, because of its shape. Remember, nerve is peripheral nervous system, so as this nerve heads toward the brain, because it's sensory, it becomes a tract, olfactory tract. Nerves become tracts as they enter the central nervous system, and this tract will lead to the temporal lobe, if you recall from the last chapter, because the temporal lobe is where olfaction is processed. Cranial nerve 3, Roman numeral 3, we should know is the oculomotor nerve. Oculo has to do with the eyes, but this time it says motor, which is a giveaway, because the next question is this cranial nerve motor, sensory, or mixed? Well, it's entirely motor, our first motor cranial nerve, and it's motor for eye movements. So this cranial nerve is going to go to the muscles around your eyes. There's 6 of them. You can see a few of them on this picture. So 4 of the 6, so most of your eye muscles, or extrinsic, which means muscles on the outside of your eye, 4 out of 6 of them are controlled by the ocular motor nerve. So cranial nerve 3, Roman numeral 3, ocular motor nerve is motor for eye movements. Cranial nerve 4, Roman numeral IV, which is 4, is called trochlear nerve. And the trochlear nerve, motor, sensory, or mixed, well, it's a motor nerve for eye movements, just like cranial nerve 3, the ocular motor nerve. So cranial nerve 4 is 1 of the 6 eye muscles. Remember, the ocular motor nerve, cranial nerve 3, is 4 of the 6. So that means there's 2 muscles left here that move the eye. One of those is controlled by the trochlear nerve. So cranial nerve 4, trochlear nerve, motor for eye movements. Cranial nerve 5, Roman numeral 5, which is a V, is the trigeminal nerve, and here we have our first mixed nerve. Mixed nerve meaning it's motor and sensory. So what's the sensory part? Well, it says sensory impulses to the face. Why can we feel things on our face? Well, it's cranial nerve 5 that's controlling that. Since it's a mixed nerve, it also has motor fibers. Motor for what? Well, for mastication, which means chewing. So this nerve will go to some muscles in the face that allow us to chew. We learn some of these muscles, like the masseter and the temporalis muscle. So we'll see that on the next slide. Cranial nerve 5 continues on the next slide. But for here, cranial nerve 5, which is Roman numeral letter V, trigeminal nerve, motor, sensory, or mixed. Well, it's a mixed nerve. Mixed for what? Sensory for the face, and motor for mastication. Continuing with the trigeminal nerve, it's called the trigeminal nerve because it has three sections. You can see the three sections. The ophthalmic section around the eye, right? The maxillary section where the maxilla is located, and the mandibular section where the mandible is located. And you see all those nerves that come from those three different areas of the face all become the sensory portion of the trigeminal nerve. Motor portion, well, there's your temporalis, there's your masseter, you have pterygoid muscles, medial and lateral, which are all chewing muscles, and that's the motor portion of the trigeminal nerve. Next, cranial nerve, number 6, which is Roman numeral 6 right here, VI is 6. Its name, abducens nerve. Abducens, well, will control, well, next question would be motor, sensory, or mixed. This is a motor cranial nerve for eye movements. Again, cranial nerve 3, the ocular motor, controlled 4 of the 6 intrinsic eye muscles, cranial nerve 4, trochlear, controlled 1 of the 6, so we still have one extrinsic eye muscle left, and here's our nerve that controls it, the abducens nerve, controls 1 of the 6 eye muscles. So recap, cranial nerve 6, VI, Roman numeral 6, abducens nerve, motor for eye movement. So 3 of the 12 cranial nerves are for eye movements and are motor only.